this is a song I wrote. Well, let's see. Let's see. I was 33, so this song is now 7 years old. But it's just as relevant as it ever was, especially now that Lady Gaga, my friend and yours, has released a new album, and the discussion turns once again to the nature of pop music. What is it, and what does it mean to you? And you might not be thinking about this question, but I certainly always am. And as it was back in the heyday of Lady Gaga's, I believe, whatever, first, second record, there was an argument going on. And I was like caught wind of this argument. And the argument was like, Lady Gaga is a good songwriter. Why is she making this terrible pop music? Terrible, according to whoever was saying it was terrible, right? Like, one could argue it's great pop music. And I found myself wanting to jump to her defense, and I wrote this, like, long, wanky blog about the nature of pop and culture and postmodernism and how all art should be allowed. And then I realized that a considered answer would be much better in song format. And so... that very night, while this discussion on my Twitter feed was exploding, I took to my YouTube channel and wrote this song and immediately uploaded it instead of posting a blog. But it's still an important topic. This song is called Gaga, Palmer, Madonna, a polemic on the state of pop music. And it is in the key of G, like all of my ukulele songs. She is a part of the music continuum, and she is part of this, oh my God, wait, delicate world. I'm gonna have to look up the lyrics. Pause. Just pause. Woohoo. Thank you. Okay.
Here we go.
Zinf, you're so light. Okay, I have the lyrics, and here we go. Palmer, no, Gaga, God, we have the lyrics, mostly. I'm going to try to do this. Gaga, Palmer, Madonna, take two. Der Standard, 2016, coming at you from the third floor. She is a part of the music continuum, and she is part of this difficult world. And she wears outfits made of aluminium. She is a 23, she is a 23, she is a 23 and a half-year-old girl. I am part of the music continuum, and I am part of this difficult world. And I'm often naked and play the accordion. I am a 33. I am a 33, I am a 33, and a half-year-old girl. She is part of the music continuum, and also part of this difficult world. And she was the first one to often have no clothes on. She is not 53, she's only 50, but I used her anyway, 'cause she fits well in this song. Art is great that way, you can do anything. You can make pop music, you can paint ducks. But if you're a pop artist and you're a woman, then it's much more likely that people will say your art sucks. Making pop music isn't for everyone. Actually, that's bullshit. It technically is. That's why it's pop music now. I've confused myself. I'm gonna start a new verse and I'll say it like this. Some artists focus on love and simplicity. Some artists focus on fashion and fame. Then sometimes some artists try to do everything, which is impossible. I think those people are brave. Art is simple, just ask Andy Warhol. If he weren't dead, he would tell you the truth. Call it a masterpiece, call it a urinal. It doesn't matter, it's art, so there's nothing to prove. I'm not sure what the point of this song is, and I know this song doesn't actually have to have any point at all even good rhymes in it, like Lady Gaga and also Madonna. I'm just trying to entertain people, make a living and pay my rent without having to get a job I hate, and hopefully find an audience that will love and accept me and not think I'm a narcissist for wanting to be a performer and find true inner peace, and that's it. One more verse. Oh my God. All right. Now a question to further our dialogue. Is all art real art, and is pop art art? And if someone talented wants to make pop music, why should we worry when there's so much other shit wrong? Thank you. Woohoo.